As firefighters scramble to connect hoses, flames take hold of the roof. Smoke filling the house. Spreading through the back of the property, quickly consuming the two-storey home. Fire visible through windows and doors. Threatening a dry cleaning business and a barber next door, with the owners watching on.
It was a garden shed at the back with a lot of combustibles at the back that took hold.
The home unable to be saved, the roof caving in as crews battled to control the flames. It took 16 firefighters and 4 trucks to put it out, 2 overcome with heat fatigue.
They were quickly assessed and there was no problems there.
Robbo and Barbara heard the fire take off from across the road.
I came outside into the back garden and looked over, and there was a great big plume of smoke coming from around the back of the house.
And then we heard bangs, so we thought, oh, gas bombs.
Their car parked right near the flames.
The Nissan X-Trail, the one right at the end.
Right where everything's happening.
The smoke could be seen from kilometres away.
This house has been the beloved family home of an elderly couple for more than a decade. Fortunately, they weren't home when the fire broke out, away for the day.
Just my uncle and my auntie, they lived here for more than 15 years.
Annie rushed to the scene when she heard, watching on with the couple's friends Bevan and Mike.
His wife is over Stradbroke Island with friends, and he went to an island to see somebody over in an island. He rang me because he didn't know what was going on at the time.
Saying they'll support the family as they come to terms with the tragedy. The cause of the fire is being investigated. Rosanna King's Sun, 7 News.